Somebody get 61, Isaiah 61 and 1. That might be. Somebody else get 1 Corinthians 10 and 23. I'm going to be all over the place, but I ain't going to be long. I'm going to hit and miss. Somebody else get Philippians 4 and 8. Who got it? Say what you got and read what you got.
Wherefore, my beloved?
What do you have? What are you reading from?
Philippians
2 and 12.
All right, congregation, Philippians 2 and 12. Uh-huh.
Wherefore, my beloved?
Wherefore, my beloved?
As ye have always obeyed.
As ye have always obeyed.
Not as in my presence.
Not as in my presence.
Only.
Only.
But now much more in my absence.
But now much more in my absence.
Work out your own personal individualized self.
Salvation with
fear and
trembling. With fear and trembling. Work out your own soul. Salvation. It didn't tell you to work out mine. You will get in trouble and miss the mark fooling with mine. You will have setbacks fooling with my salvation.
Amen.
Work out your own individual, personalized self, you, salvation, with fear and trembling. And if you put the required time into you, you won't have time for me. Oh, y'all not saying amen.
Yeah.
Glory to God. What is my point? My point is that you're getting into a lot of trouble and you're not anywhere near where God wants you to be and the blessings that God wants you to have because you're too busy trying to work out somebody else's salvation. Work out your own. Work on yourself.
Yeah.
And leave God to everybody
else. Thank you now. I'm sorry. We might not like that. But when did we get to the point that we got it so together as an individual that we had time to work on yours and there's still flaws in
yours? Yes.
Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
And the reason, listen, here's what we're dealing with today. I wrote some stuff as I was sitting here. Here's the spirit that's upon the church today that's in the midst of the church. Negativity. All I need to hear is amen.
Amen.
Heaviness.
Heaviness.
Spirit of depression.
Yeah.
Spirit of discouragement. Spirit of guilt. Spirit of quilt.
Yep.
The spirit of quit. The spirit of not accepting. The spirit of rejection. The spirit of backsliding. The spirit of pity. The spirit of resentment. Somebody shout amen.
Amen. That's it.
All the different spirits coming in here. And this ain't coming through the unsaved. This is coming through them who say they've been born again.
Yeah.
Baptized believers in Christ Jesus. Them that's got the Holy Ghost and power. And a mighty burning fire. Y'all not talking back to me. Glory to God. This spirit is upon you.
Bless us, Lord.
And you know why? Because we're too busy trying to work out everybody else's salvation.
That's a good word.
Work out your own
salvation
with
fear, trembling.
Fear and trembling don't come on me about you. It comes on me about me. Hallelujah.
not pray for your brother or sister, that don't mean not witness effectively.
Yeah.
But you got to back up and look after yourself before anybody else.
Make it plain.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
Huh? And part of that is if you got an ought against your brother or your sister, the Bible says.
Yes.
You better take your little gift and lay it where? Don't be scared to speak it here. The Bible is scared to speak about. Lay your gift at the altar and do what?
Go.
Get it right.
Get it right.
Amen. How well a gift you got? How well you preach? How good you prophesy? If you got alt, bitterness, problem, something against,
amen.
You're not talking back to me.
Amen.
You better go lay it down because it'll affect you.
Amen.
It'll affect the atmosphere.
Amen.
It will affect and hinder the move of God. Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Ooh, God.
Until you do what? Go work out your own soul salvation. With fear and trembling. I know y'all happy about the word of God. See, I didn't write this. It was written. I know y'all happy. What you got next? In the order that I called it in, please.
It was 62.
Was it Isaiah or was it Philippians 2 or 20? You got me.
Isaiah
61 and 1. I'm trying to get finished, but y'all ain't got the scriptures I gave you.
And the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me.
Isaiah spoke in the prophet. And the Spirit of the Lord God is upon who?
On me.
Who?
Upon me.
Who?
Me.
Who? I can't get enough people. Who?
Me.
Us. What's it say? I need to correct it. Us.
Me.
The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. Otherwise, that makes me personally responsible and accountable for it. And the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me.
Yeah.
Personal. Responsible. Accountable.
Yeah.
It's upon me. The maintenance is upon me. Read it.
Because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings.
Because the Lord has appointed me.
Anointed.
Like y'all scared to speak the Bible. What? Is it in there?
Anointed me.
The Lord has appointed me.
Anointed me.
Oh, it's anointed me.
Anointed me.
That's a little higher level than appointed, right?
Yes, sir.
It comes from a greater authority, right?
Yeah.
All right, the Lord has anointed me, meaning to be effective.
To preach good tidings to the meek.
To preach bad tidings.
Good tidings.
Bad news.
Good tidings.
Rumors and hearsay.
Good tidings.
Good tidings. Good. Come on, get that in your spirit. Good. Say it until it feels good. Good. Because it's a hard thing to get us changed.
Good.
All we know is bad.
Good Lord, bless us.
Ain't no way in Genesis you gonna find where Jesus said, "I created the heavens and the earth and made man." And he
bad.
Said, "Man, anything." I saw it in good. That's a scary word.
That's what
I can go. Yeah, something good.
It's good.
Because everything in the church now is bad. Hello here, y'all.
No. Bless us.
There's a seed planet that everything we do is bad.
No.
Come on.
We don't do nothing right.
Come on.
No. We don't do nothing good. Hello, somebody.
No. Come on.
All of us in here is bad.
No.
We all a bunch of hypocrites.
Come on.
We all on our way to heaven, going to hell. Come on, somebody.
Come on.
There's nothing hardly good to say about us in church.
Come on.
We don't pray right. We don't read right. We don't preach right. We don't teach right. We don't anoint right. We don't appoint right. Ain't nothing right about us.
Jesus. Jesus. Help us.
God has anointed. God has made you effective.
Yeah.
God has authorized you. God has backed you.
Come on.
God, through his name, has given you power.
To do what?
Preach.
Yeah, yeah. Good Lord.
Good tidings, good tidings. Well, Alan, I can't get enough. Good. G-O-D don't sound like B-A-D. Good tidings. To the meek.
Yeah.
Well, that's the anointing you for.
Look at your neighbor and say, if you be anointed in the first place.
Oh, Lord, bless us.
What else did he anoint you for?
Jesus.
He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted.
He sent me, or I went.
Oh, good Lord, sent me.
He sent me, or I was lent.
Sent me. He sent me.
He, who has the power.
Yeah.
The authority, the backing, has sent me.
Yeah.
To do what?
Bind up the brokenhearted.
To bind up the brokenhearted or to break your heart?
Bind it up.
Bind up the brokenhearted.
Good Lord.
There's something wrong here.
If he sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, I don't have no business in here breaking your heart. Ask your neighbor, are you a heartbreaker?
Bless the Lord. I know you ain't a heartbreaker. I hope not.
Something wrong. I think sometimes we get more heartbreak in here than we get out there.
Well, come on, Bishop.
Oh, ain't something wrong?
Come on, Bishop. Ooh, God.
He sent me to bind up.
Help us, Lord.
To heal. To mend. The brokenhearted.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Read it.
To proclaim liberty to the captives.
To proclaim bondage.
Liberty.
Prison.
Liberty.
Chains.
Liberty.
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 To the captives.
To them that are in captive.
Those that are captive. Yeah.
Now, Alan, that's what I've been trying to do, bring liberty back to the church, to the people of God. Hello? And I still got some folk working their best against it.
Oh, Lord, bless us.
Huh?
Bless us.
You may not know it, see, when the people got brought out of Egypt, they were liberated. They were free.
Yeah.
But the problem with it was they came out with an Egypt mentality. Kind of like being institutionalized. Y'all not hearing me, please.
Great.
Hallelujah. God is trying to bring liberty back to the church so that you can do and preach that which is good, that you can heal the brokenhearted. Hello, somebody. And you can be effective in your anointing.
Yeah.
But you can't be effective in you bound.
Good Lord, help us.
Y'all not talking back to me.
Come on.
Well, what does it mean by that? I know God saved me, yeah, but over here you can't do nothing.
Good Jesus. Lord.
Lord. I'm in the church. I can't do nothing. Can't go nowhere. Just bide my time until I go into heaven. Just occupying until it comes. Well, do what you want to do. What you want to do?
Help us, Lord.
Where you want to go?
Good Lord.
Go, baby. You're free.
Bless us.
Come on. Can't have no program. Can't sell no chicken dinner. Can't have a fish mind. We just are bound up.
Come on, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Come on, God.
You said the liberty is under the captain. First of all, you're captivated in your mind. And you get captivated like that when you don't have enough time to work out your own soul salvation.
Amen.
Hello?
Yeah.
Glory to God. When you don't have time to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling, then you get captivated in your mind. Glory to God, you find fault with everything. I said fault finders.
Yeah.
Fault finders. Whispers. Listen, if you got somebody constantly whispering in your ear, back up, back away, move your seat from them kind of people.
Bless the Lord.
Hello? Ain't nothing they got positive to say? They don't think positive? It's negativity raining all the time. Negativity, 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 negativity.
Yeah.
Husbands are messed up for negative wives. Wives are messed up for negative husbands. Preachers are messed up for negative church mothers. Church mothers are messed up for negative pastors. Don't want to hear me here. It just keeps going on and on and on and on. Kids are messed up for negative parents. Parents are messed up for negative kids. Don't want to hear me.
Yeah.
Negativity, negativity,
negative. Negative. Yeah.
Bishop, preach.
They don't like you. You've been out of shape. What else is new?
Been out of shape.
Not only will people speak, the enemy will speak. They don't want to hear you, Bishop. They don't want to see you. They don't want you there. Hello, somebody. Glory to God. Amen. What else did it anoint you for, Ella Ward?
And to opening of the prison to them that are bound.
Open the prison to them that are bound. Somebody get Philippians 4 and 8. Let me skip over. Who got 4 and 8? Philippians.
I have Philippians 4 and 8.
What's it say?
For the rest, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is worthy of reverence and is honorable and seemly, whatever is just, whatever is pure.
That's good. What version? Is that the New King James Version? Yeah. Is that the NIV?
New? Yeah.
That's good. That's New King James Version. But I want the old King James.
Right, brethren. Whatsoever things are true.
Whatsoever things are true.
Yeah.
Read it.
Whatsoever things are honest.
Whatsoever things are honest.
Whatsoever things are just.
Whatsoever things are just.
Whatsoever things are pure.
Whatsoever things are pure.
Whatsoever things are lovely.
Whatsoever things are lovely.
Yeah, yeah.
Whatsoever things are of good report.
Whatsoever things are of good report.
Good report.
If there be any virtue.
If there be any virtue.
And if there be any praise,
think on these things. Think.
Yeah. Yeah.
On these things.
Think on that.
Think.
Ooh, God.
With nothing in there negative.
Amen.
Whatever's honest, pure, just, lovely. Think.
Yeah.
On these things. Hallelujah. Mind can't, preacher, you cannot preach on the anointing always in this gospel. Mind tainted with all kind of negativity. Does not work, does not connect.
That's good.
Does not compute.
That's good.
It's unaffected. How you think about one another, how you think about the house of God. Hello, somebody. That's another form of working out your own soul salvation. You think of people as you think of yourself.
Yeah.
You are what you
eat. I think. Think, eat.
What you intake.
Yes.
Your thought process needs to be healthy. It needs to be spiritual. Glory to God.
Wow.
I don't really have a whole bunch of time to be thinking bad about you because I had too much bad in my own past to be thinking bad about you. I'm still trying to get healed from some of the junk in my own past. Hello, somebody.
Come on, Bishop.
I don't have time to spend my days thinking negative and bad about you. Because if you ever understood what people thought about you, you wouldn't put that energy into thinking it about somebody else. Because it don't feel good at all.
Amen, that's right.
There's nothing spiritually, nor naturally, nor physically healthy about it.
Yeah.
Everybody wants to be respected. Everybody wants to be liked. Everybody wants to be accepted.
Yes, sir.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
You know, they don't like you. Hey, get away from them people. Get as far away from that kind of folk you can. They don't accept it. I got news for you. I didn't find out something. Now God likes me.
All right.
Amen.
And then he loves me.
Yeah.
Liking me all the way since the devil is a lie. He liked me all the way from Genesis before I even got here. God liked my DNA. I don't remember your message. God liked my DNA in my mother's womb.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
He knew me.
Yes.
In the mama's womb, he knew me.
Yes.
My thoughts of you are good and not bad.
Yeah.
And they're not bad. They're not evil.
God, thank you.
Give you an expected end.
I know what you're going to turn out to be. The biggest, the best, and the brightest.
That's a good word.
Say that. Amen. Whatsoever things. If I got to fight through it, then I'm going to fight through it.
Yeah.
I'm not going to allow you to feed me negativity. Lies. Things of dishonor. Things that make me look or frown.
You're saying it. You're saying it, Bishop.
All right.
Wow.
Not healthy.
Help us, Lord.
Not good. First Corinthians 10:23. Who got it? All things
work together for good.
No, that ain't it. First Corinthians 10:23. How about all things are lawful?
All things are lawful for me.
Talk about that liberation.
But all things are not expedient.
All things are lawful, but all things are not expedient. Listen, I want to tell you people that preach, that teach, that evangelize.
Yep.
I know you're operating in old school where you thought you could get on the floor and say anything you want to. You can't.
Amen.
And you that are, you got to stop.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Stop. Instantly, immediately, this second.
Wow. Wow.
You can't say anything you want to.
Make it plain. Yeah.
You got to speak what God told me. No. God doesn't work against himself.
Amen.
I'm sorry. God don't work against himself.
That's a big amen.
Huh? Out of the same mouth come bitter and sweet water, blessing and cursing. Out of the same speaking, bitter and sweet water, blessing and cursing. Out of the same. God does not work. Again,
amen.
All things work together for the good of the Lord, which is the call according to his purpose. But sometimes you're going by yourself. But if the Lord anointed you to preach to the people, you have got to hear what God said, what the Spirit said unto the church.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can't say anything you want. And I'm going to tell you something else. Tell you something, everybody ain't in a place to set the church in order.
Right.
Stop trying to set the church in order, work out your own.
So fast. That's a big amen. Thank you.
You'll lose your walk with God trying to set the church in order. I gotta share one thing with you. There's nothing wrong with the church.
Yeah.
All right.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with the church.
Wow.
There's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing spotted about it. There's nothing bad about it. Mm. Upon this rock, Peter, I build my church.
My church, yes, sir.
And the very gates of hell shall not prevail against it. There may be something wrong with people who come around the church.
Yeah.
But there's nothing wrong with the church. The church is a body of baptized believers in Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
And nothing is wrong with the church. The Bible says that God is coming back for a church without spot, wrinkle, or blemish. There is nothing wrong church.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good. Stop getting up and talking about the church, the church. The problem is with people.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
People who are around the church, but there's nothing wrong with the church. Don't waste your time in your ministry trying to set the church in order. God already has it in order.
All right.
Huh?
That's a good word.
If you want to really set the church in order, it's what loving kindness have I drawn unto you.
That's the
book. That's how you got around here. Loving kindness have I drawn unto you, Jeremiah 31. Loving kindness have I drawn unto you.
Yeah.
That's how you got here with loving kindness. Amen. I didn't whoop you up in here.
Amen.
I heard the testimony. He didn't whoop you up in here.
Mm-mm.
You came willingly. And then he ministered to you.
Yeah.
Look at somebody and say, minister to me.
Minister to me.
He ministered to me.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you one thing now. If I was a sinner looking for a church and needed to be saved, I probably wouldn't join or get saved. Because when you get up here and say all the stuff you say out of your mouth, that the church is wrong, the pulpit is wrong, the motherboard is wrong, the evangelistic department is wrong, and I'm already wrong. So look at the church. I'm condemned before I get in here.
Yeah.
So we don't have to stop that stuff.
Yes, yes.
That's good. That's good.
Tearing up one another, battling one another. The unsaved here, that they're not gonna get saved because all of you who say you saved was just told on the floor, you ain't nothing. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. All things are lawful.
Yeah.
But it's not expedient.
Oh yeah.
You have the liberty to say what you want. That's your freedom of speech. But I'll tell you one thing. You're going to answer for the one. Offenses come, but woe who they come.
That's the truth.
Offenses don't come.
Yeah.
They don't come.
Yeah.
Good Lord bless us.
But woe who they come through.
Yeah.
Man, that's in the book.
Any man who does not offend in word and deed, the same is
a perfect man.
A perfect man. Huh?
Yeah.
But when you are anointed. You're accountable and you're responsible. Don't get so caught up in the spirit you say anything. People call God's people all kind of names. I may not be on the same ladder you and I may not be where you are in your faith, but good God, I'm on my way.
God
is still my God. I'm still a child of God. I'm still in the work and I'm still on the potter's wheel.
Amen.
There's some people that come through here and said some harsh things too and about
Amen, Bishop. That's the truth.
Hallelujah.
Then you go after the whole church trying to get one somebody together.
Jesus.
And you say amen.
Amen.
The best advice when people come to talking that foolishness and craziness. Listen here. First of all, you tell them the best thing is just, I don't want to hear it. I'm sorry. I don't mean offense. I don't mean to be disrespectful. But I want to hear it. I don't want to pollute my spirit with that mess. Because whatsoever things are lovely, pure, honest, and of good report, think on these things. If there be any virtue, be any praise, think on these things.
Yeah.
And baby, I'm fixing to work on my own soul salvation. I don't have time to hear that foolishness. Most folk want to hear it and then say, we'll pray about it.
Yeah.
But you already took the garbage in. You pollute it.
Yeah. Amen.
You pollute it. Because of their temptation. I got to hear it through. I can feel negative when it's coming.
Amen. Amen. Yeah.
You can hear it. You can feel it when it's coming.
Feel it.
The way they start off.
Amen.
You already know it ain't going to end good. Then when I get through filling your spirit up with the mess and the junk, then I say, we ought to pray about it. Now, what you ought to do is pray that you learn what to hear, what to receive, and what not to hear and what to receive.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you say amen.
Amen. Amen.
I understand you.
I'm not going to hear nothing. I don't have the power to do nothing about no how, Elkhart.
Yeah.
All right.
You don't have the power to do nothing with it.
Amen. That's a big, so, amen, it's so big.
You can't change it. So don't hear it.
Oh, my God.
Hallelujah.
Oh.
I understand we're human, but it gets tempting to hear something on somebody. We love to hear stuff on somebody.
Come on, Bishop.
I heard Raymond.
Mm-mm.
I saw.
Mm-mm.
Say he had somebody in the car with him. How many cars I passed a day with somebody in the car with somebody?
All right.
Mm-mm.
Help.
Mm-mm.
Help.
Hallelujah.
Help.
Say you were going in the house.
You go just like yes. That. Mm-mm.
They were setting out to eat. Very few restaurants I go in, I'm sitting in there by myself.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It's trying to generate something negative or make something out of nothing.
Praise God.
And it pollutes your spirit. Can you say that?
Amen.
Glory to God.
Wow.
I'm too busy working out my own fear.
Yes.
My own soul.
Whew, that was a good word.
Salvation. Remember, all things are lawful. But not all things
are expedient.
Are expedient. Hit Romans 1 and 16. I'm going to close the book because we got to go. Romans 1:16. Is that something about I'm not ashamed?
Well, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ.
For I am not ashamed of the gossip.
Gospel.
Gospel.
Thank God for that. Because I can close my book. Thank God. Thank God, it was on the manual. But I'm not ashamed of the gospel.
Right. Of Christ.
Yeah.
Christ.
Yeah.
What's it say?
For it is the power of God unto salvation.
For it is the power of God unto separation.
Salvation. Salvation.
It is the power of God unto salvation.
Yeah.
To everyone that believeth.
To the church folk that believeth.
To everyone that believeth.
To the ones that come to church that believeth.
To everyone
that believeth. To anyone and everyone that believeth.
Yeah.
I'm not ashamed of the gospel.
Right.
And what is the gospel?
Good news.
The what?
The good news.
Good news.
Amen.
Ooh, God. Thank
I'm
you.
Not ashamed of it. Good news. For it is the power.
Yeah.
Other words, when you are preaching and teaching the gospel, it should not separate. It doesn't bring separation. It brings salvation.
Salvation.
Amen.
It's the power of salvation.
Yeah.
You're going to have to start using phrases like, I know y'all don't like me. I know y'all mad.
Jesus.
I know y'all can't stand. And do you not know that when people say that enough in one message, you'll find yourself not liking them?
Good Lord. Wow.
You'll find yourself not liking what they're saying. First of all, because you're operating in the wrong spirit. There's nothing about the word of God, which is good news, the gospel, that you shouldn't like.
Yeah.
Amen.
Huh? John 8:32 said, you shall what? Know the truth.
And the truth shall make you free.
The truth didn't come to set you in bondage.
Mm-mm.
It didn't come to hurt you.
No, sir.
I don't know where you come from, but the truth hurt. That ain't Bible either.
Come on.
The truth hurt. That ain't scripture. It ain't nowhere in the Bible. It said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Yeah.
And anybody in bondage and error wants to be free.
Yeah.
That means it'll work itself. You don't have to try to work it. All you got to do is put the truth out there. And he said, my word will cut.
Yeah.
Marrow. It'll pierce, cut bone, get all in the fragments, get all down in the marrow, in the bone.
Help us, Lord.
That's what the word of God do.
Yeah.
It's sharper
than any two-edged sword.
The words don't need to be sharp. The word is sharp.
It's already sharp.
Huh?
I don't need to help it to be sorry.
Join all of your joints.
Amen.
When the word come off of righteous, move up to those joints.
Oh, God.
You don't feel no pain.
God. Don't badger the people of God.
Yes, sir.
Y'all.
Hmm.
This is that. You ain't this, you ain't that.
Hmm.
Because the Son of Man ain't coming. Mm. He said, wow.
Hmm.
Do you hear that? Their church is messed up.
Wow. Yes, sir. Wow.
There's enough good news in there to preach about Jesus Christ. The love of God. Huh? I chose to know nothing else among you but Christ Jesus and Him crucified.
Yeah.
Huh?
Mm.
I don't need to know nothing else about you. I got enough on errors in my own life.
Bless us, Lord.
Huh? Come and put your hands together and give God praise.